أهلا بيكم، وأحب أقدم لكم جوناثان. جوناثان is senior teaching fellow in Arabic at the University of Edinburgh and a teacher trainer in integrated and communicative approach. Jonathan also is the author of BBC Talk Arabic and Arabiyat al-Nas fi Masr, and currently working on two books, Arabiyat al-Nas 2 and Intensive Arabic. There is a lot to say about Jonathan, but I won't, عشان to give the time ان انتوا تعملوا الworkshop. اتفضل يا جوناثان، وممكن تعمل share للpresentation.
Yes. Shukran. I'm going to do this in English because I think there may be one or two people here that maybe don't know Arabic, and I think we can apply it, even though I will be referring to some Arabic texts. But before I actually go into the presentation, I would like first to talk to you a little bit about how I interpret the integrated approach. Now, as we all know, Arabic has variation in that we have the standard form of the language, the modern standard Arabic, which is perhaps a derivation of Quranic Arabic originally, but nevertheless, it's a fairly relatively modern construct. And then, of course, we have dialects, and then there are many levels of discourse between the very sort of low level, if you like, uneducated speaker. I don't like to use that word, but you know, there are levels of language. Now, some people believe that integrated approach is where you teach in your institution, you teach modern standard Arabic, and you also teach a dialect. Mainly separately. And that's what happened to me when I did my Arabic degree at SOAS many, many years ago. We did Fusha, but I was very lucky that I was able to do a course of Egyptian Arabic, but we also looked at the linguistics of it. We had to study plays like a Rihani and Nasili 4 and lots of interesting things in Egyptian Arabic, but it was an academic course rather than just a language course, but we looked at phonetics and other things, but it was very much kept very separate from the modern standard Arabic. My first teaching job was I taught for many years with the military, and this is how I got to know Farida, because we would send our students to Kalimat to ILI in Cairo for their period abroad. But what would happen in the military academy was that students would do an intensive 10-week course of colloquial Arabic, and it was Gulf Arabic that they did, because a lot of the military students would then end up working in the Gulf countries, not all of them, but some, the majority did. And that would be 35 hours a week for 10 weeks. So you can imagine on an intensive level to what level they got to in speaking, because they didn't do any Fusha, they didn't even learn the script, because that wasn't part of the requirement. And then those military students that had to go to a much higher level would then be switched to the long course. So after the 10 weeks, where they would start doing Fusha and going up to quite a high level, reading, you know, media and various other types of things that would be interesting for them. But at the same time, we would continue using Amiya as a vehicle through which they could speak. So at the beginning, it wasn't integrated, because you had the colloquial base, but then it became integrated after the intensive period. I then, after working there, I moved to the Foreign Office and I taught diplomats. And again, but there they studied both Amiya and Fusha together from day one. So by the time they got to study in the Arab world, they were already, after 6 or 7 months in London, they were able to communicate quite well once, as Farida would remember, once they arrived in Egypt, they already knew quite a lot of Egyptian Arabic and they were able to function. Okay, they made some mistakes and they had issues with comprehension, but overall they were ready to go with the flow. It's a little bit like, you know, when you're driving and you join the motorway, you're driving at 30 miles an hour in the city, and the cars are going at 70 miles an hour, you want to be able to join it. Maybe you have to accelerate up to about 50, 55, so you don't crash, you join. If you know, if you send students to the Arab world where they only know Fusha, there will be a crash, they will crash. And that will result in frustration, linguistic, crashing, of course, not physical. So that's how it worked. And so when I started working in Edinburgh with the master's course, I wanted to do the same thing where we integrated Fusha and Amiya. Even when we're teaching Fusha texts or whether we're teaching translation or anything, I believe that for me, integration is where the two are integrated. So if I were to, if Georgia was one of my students, I would say to her, so I'm multi in better here, Georgia. I'm multi in better. Ulili better. I'm multi in.
مثل كأني طالبة.
امبارح.
اوكي. امبارح حضرت بمؤتمر.
ممتاز. وبعدين؟
وبعدين بالليل شو عملت بالليل؟ درست شوي. بعدين طلعت من البيت لعمل كل اليوم العمام طلعت. طلعت من البيت يعني شنو ساعة تمشيت وبعدين رجعت ونمت.
ممتاز ممتاز. طيب. So هنا هي بتقولي هي عملت امبارح وطبعا لما بتكتب انا عايزها تكتب لي امس ذهبت الى المؤتمر حضرت المؤتمر ومن بعد رجعت الى البيت ومشيت الى اخره. So the idea is that I wouldn't teach Georgia the past tense in Amiya without teaching her that in Fusha as well. I would like her to be able to write at home, having thought a little bit about what she told me, to maybe write me a short essay about what she did. Because speaking in Fusha is always a little bit more difficult, you know, fast. But when you sit down and you have time to write, you can do it. And so that's what I mean about full integration. Now that was with a structure, grammatical structure. If we're teaching a text about a city, it could be about Beirut, مثلاً ممكن الطالب يقرأ ناس, the student can read a text about Beirut in Fusha, but they could discuss it in Amiya, they could ask each other questions about Beirut in Amiya. And of course, you have to provide them with the correct structures, and that's very important. So today, what I want to look at is a real challenge that I had, because first of all, we had Corona, and then everything went online, and I was asked to teach translation for second year undergraduates for the first time, translating passages from English into Arabic. This is the first time they had to do this because they're lower intermediate, but it's part of the course. The course is a topic-based course, second year. This particular sample I will show you is from something that I taught in the last semester one in Edinburgh, and it's based on shopping. The whole topic is to do with shopping. And one of the aspects of the course is for them to translate from English into Arabic. And as Alaa, you may have heard earlier, was talking about this issue of synchronous and asynchronous. This is something we're going to be looking at today as to whether or, you know, how you deliver such a thing online. Can it be done completely asynchronously? Should it be all synchronously or can it be a mix of both? So without further ado, I shall share my screen. Farida, please tell me if it's working.
Harder.
Aywa. I hope it is. Shaghal?
Not yet. La.
Lisa? I pressed it. Does it say it's going to
لا,
work?
لا بس افتح الأول الدوكيمنت وبعدين وبعدين اعمل شير سكرين على الحتة اللي انت حتعمل لها شيء.
Okay.
أيوة بدأت جاي لنا هي في الطريق.
كتبت شير.
جاي خلاص هي نازلة هي لسه ما شفناهاش كومبليتلي بس تقريبا جاي في السكة يعني.
Is it there?
أيوة خلاص جات حلوة قوي أيوة كبر السكرين بقى
الحمد لله أنا هعمل له سلايد شو بقى من البداية
أوكي
سلايد شو I press slide show but it doesn't seem to
لا هو حلو خلاص حلو
yeah that's it fantastic okay right so what are the aims of the workshop the workshop is based on a translation you I don't know whether I need to go back to the first slide
ارجع تاني للأولاني بس عشان خاطر ال participants يشوفوا العنوان.
Okay, let me go back. Okay, so it's the blended model and the integrated approach, challenges and solutions. So that's the title of what I've spoken a little bit about, the background of how I see the integrated approach and how I think it should work. That's my own interpretation of it. People interpret it in different ways. And now I want to now look at the test case that we're going to look at today. And the test case is teaching English to Arabic, modern standard Arabic, to year two undergraduate Arabic, which I think is lower intermediate, roughly. And here are the challenges. How to help a large group of students of around 15 and maybe over, it was between 15 and 20, which I think is a similar size that you have Georgia in Exeter, to handle basic translation into Arabic online, whilst adhering to the philosophy of the integrated approach, to enable active online participation of students. I don't want them to get bored. I know their cameras are switched off, but I still want them to talk and to interact. To incorporate an element of spoken Arabic and to revise and consolidate certain structures where a clear diglossic gap exists between MSA and spoken. That was my challenge, that I felt that if I'm going to do this, I have to incorporate something like a diglossic gap structure. What do I mean by a diglossic gap structure? I'm talking about where there's a clear division between Fosha grammar and Amiya grammar. So for example, if we're talking about, let's say, Laysa and Mish, yeah? Lastu Masriyan ana Mish Masri. There, that's quite different, yeah? However, if I say, masalan, Farida sit masriya, I don't know, Farida sit masriya, or Farida imra'atun masriyatun, the adjective noun is not such a big problem, so we don't need to spend extra time on that. But there are certain structures where the difference is big, and we'll be looking at one of those structures later. And then, of course, as in this workshop, I have to stick to the time limit of 1 hour. So I have my watch here because I'm going to be demonstrating to you a number of exercises, which I want you to look at. And then when we finish, we're going to evaluate them as to how good you think, how effective you think they are in achieving the aim, and whether you think that they could be done, whether it would be better to do these asynchronously, so the student could do them at home before they come to the class, or whether they should be done all asynchronously, or whether they could be done all asynchronously, or whether, so we can decide that together, inshallah, at the end. So let's now start with what I'm going to do. I'm going to demonstrate a number of suggested exercises. I want you to evaluate these exercises. I want us to think about in terms of whether we achieve our aim, and the aim must always be, in my opinion, to support our students. That's what we're here to do, to support them. But imagine, you know, they've never translated from English to Arabic before, and I can imagine it was really scary for them. And they had done all the basic structures, both in modern standard Arabic and in spoken, but they'd never actually translated short passages, but it was part of their curriculum and they have to do it. And to reflect on whether, and that wasn't my decision, I was teaching on someone else's course, but that's fine, there's nothing wrong with that. To reflect, and then finally, we need to reflect on to whether or not the integrated approach as I see it can be implemented with online teaching, or whether maybe it may not be that possible. Maybe it's better just to say, khalas, let's just teach Fusha on its own, and we'll do spoken Arabic on its own. Maybe it's no longer viable to do it online. That's another question that I'm asking myself, and I think it's something that we can discuss, inshallah, at the end. So let's now continue. And I'm going to first of all show you the three texts. Remember, we said that the topic was to do with shopping in the Arab world. So these are the three texts. Text one is the easiest one. Opening hours. Mouths are open from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. And remember, I had a rough idea where these year one students were at. And maybe you might suddenly, as a teacher, get a new job, or you're starting, I don't know, and they might say, you know, that's it. This year, you're going to teach this group of students and you're going to have to teach them this. And you have to quickly think, what would they know? What wouldn't they know? You have to maybe think ahead. Would they know this structure? Maybe they don't know that. So this is the text, shopping, shops outside malls, or those at bazaars close around noon. And you can see close, reopen, fun at night, locals go out. So there's some vocabulary maybe that they might need. Let's now go on to the next. There are three texts. Next text, slightly harder. Text two, the Dubai Shopping Festival. And the task at the end for homework, they need to translate. They have to translate minimum of one of these texts. If they can manage two, then so that's even better. So the Dubai Shopping Festival, it involves not only citywide sales and promotions, but also car raffles that are drawn daily with Porsches and et cetera, fireworks. There is something for everyone at the Dubai Shopping Festival. Yes, children, so on, form of street fairs, have entertainment, even cultural performance. Here you could learn about Dubai's pearl diving history, and children love the camel rides. And then finally, bargaining. Bargaining is only applicable, slightly harder, at the souks if you do not participate. And these were texts from my colleague Marwa. So this is her course, and these are the texts that she wanted the students to be able to translate. I can't remember which week this was in the course. It was somewhere in the middle, I think, or maybe the earlier part. If you do not partake, you need to understand that you will be paying at least double the value, and so on. The rule is to ask. So about Bahi will counter offer you. So quite tricky, quite difficult, the third one, actually, I think, for year two. But still, this is what was on the syllabus. So those are our texts. We're now going to look at the exercises. Now, exercise one is a vocabulary matching. So let's have a look. Nimra wahid, ibadah. Ibadah batimshi ma'e bil-lugha al-ingliziyya. Ya Sara. ممكن تقولي لي من فضلك؟ يا سارة نهاد
ورشب
ايوه ايوه انا معاكم لحظه معاكم
عباده
اسفه يلا اي تمام غيره
ممتاز
يلا غيره
نمره اثنين تقليدي يا جورجيا
لحظه تقييم يلا يا جورجيا
تقليدي بيمشي مع
ام يا جورجيا يلا غششت ام
عفوا ما كنت قادره اشيل الانميوت عفوا
ممتاز so that's exercise one. So you know I would ask the students to say to have a look and okay كويس so هذا تمرين رقم واحد. I'm going to go through these quite quickly because I want to show there are 10 altogether. These are to help support the students translate the text. This one is to help them with the vocabulary first that they're going to need for text number one. Okay, دلوقتي. Now, here we're going to look at the first sentence. Opening hours. Malls are open from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Some, however, are not open until 2 p.m. on Fridays, the Muslim day of worship. Shops outside malls or those at bazaars close around noon for lunch and rest and reopen around 5 p.m. So here, what I did this time, sorry, I need to go back, I'm sorry. What I did this time was I wrote some questions on the right-hand side about the text. So the students, you look at the English because you're going to have to translate it for homework. So مثلا نمرة you've got to match الأسئلة مع الأجوبة. So مثلا سؤال نمرة واحد متى تكون مراكز التسوق مفتوحة في دبي? Now look at the text in English. Which, so number one goes with which letter? مين بيعرف?
I think D.
فريدة?
D.
D. بالضبط مراكز التسوق مفتوحة من الساعة 10 صباحا حتى 10 مساء. بالضبط. Let's do one more. ثلاثة. لماذا يعتبر يوم الجمعة يوما مميزا في دبي? مين بيعرف الجواب?
Me as in boy.
بالضبط. لأنه يوم العبادة الإسلام. بالضبط. So that's the the next exercise. So that gives them, gets them into thinking about how are they going to translate this passage. Let's now continue. Now, the next bit, I'm going to show you the final sentence. The whole shopping experience is most fun at night when the locals go out in their traditional Arab attire, shopping and dining at the mouse. Wow. So we've got al-ghada taqlidiya, malabisihim, al-tasawwuq, tagriba, al-mahalliyun, wa mut'a. So awwal faragh haykun a min biyaraf. تجربة التسوق كلها هي الأكثر
متعة.
أيوة في الليل عندما يخرج السكان ال
محليون.
أيوة بالضبط. شفتوا بقى؟ You see, it's fun. I hope you like it. Anyway, so it gets us into the
element very important.
The translation, and so people, and it's interactive. You know, we're in a group, and yet we're talking and doing that. So next one.
Jonathan, عفواً عندي سؤال. الطلاب يشتغلوا كلهم مع بعض ولا يعملوا هدول التمارين التدريبات يعني بالbreakout rooms؟
No, this. لا, this the ال الحصة بتاعتي هنتكلم بعدين بس دي أنا بعملها كمجموعة واحدة وبس بسأل طالب. So لو في طلبة بيحطوا نقطة الاستفهام على الشاشة وبيردوا ولكن بنعملها كمجموعة واحدة ولكن ممكن يعملوها في breakout rooms كمان يا جورج دي كمان
يعني ممكن حسب كمية الطلاب الموجودين.
Yeah, بالضبط دي كمان فكرة بس أنا عملته تقريبا مع 15 وبصراحة كان مشي كويس عشان المشكلة في إدنبرا بنستعمل teams وما فيش breakout rooms للأسف. ولكن أعتقد بالبريك روم هيمشي كويس قوي.
Okay, معلش so أنا هطلب بس نخلي الأسئلة في الآخر عشان أنت تلحق تخلص البرزنتيشن وبعدين عندنا وقت كتير للأسئلة.
شكرا يا فريدة. ده مفيد. Yes, I think it would be easier. Okay, so we'll do questions at the end. So we're now on exercise 3. I'm going to move to exercise 4. Now, what I wanted to do is for each text, I wanted to focus on one grammar area, and we'll notice in the text there was the word maftuh, open. So I and mughlaq. So we've got some passive participles. I gave them some more. So maktub, maftuh, mughlaq, mafhum, ma'ruf, matlub, and they had to again fill the gaps of Quran al-Karim, ba'd, marakiz at-tasawwuq, yom al-jum'ah, hal hadha dars. Inshallah, and so on. So that was to practice a little bit of grammar, but you'll notice that this is still fusha, although this is also spoken. I mean, we would say a dars mafhum, a dars mish mafhum. So that, and then they had to translate those into English. That took them away from the text for a few minutes, but it gave them a little bit of a breather, and it kind of added, took away the kind of stress of the text, because you know those texts are scary, and so this kind of just changed the pace a little bit of the class to do something of the sentences a little bit simpler and to recap on basic vocabulary, you know, that they just to remind them of basic words that they've already covered. So then we go on to the next text 2, the Dubai Shopping Festival. Again, you have a quick look at the text. It involves, I've underlined what I thought were the difficult words, and it was up to me. I looked at it, I thought, it involves raffles, drawn daily, fireworks, displayed, entertainment. So I kind of tried to find the words that I thought maybe would be hard. You could choose your own. And then I did another word matching, you know, mahragan and so on, which we've done one of those already. So I did a word matching for that. So shamal yashmul, to include, to involve, and so on. Next exercise. This time I wanted to do something different, to some variety. So this text, I've taken the text and I've divided it into short sections on the left. It involves not only city wild sales and promotions, 3, but also involves car raffles, 4, with Porsches as the prize, 5, and fireworks displays at night, 6. So the text has been cut into pieces. In the right-hand side, the text has been translated into Arabic, but it has been jumbled. So you have to unjumble it to make sure that you match the number one with the correct Arabic. So let's have a go. Nimra Wahid, the Dubai Shopping Festival. Wahid bimshi ma ay harf bil lugha al ingliziya. Min biaraf?
B.
B. B, bravo. Mahragan Dubai. Littasawuk. It name. It involves not only city wild sales and promotion.
C.
Aywa. Ya fannas. Wow. Inti talibah kwayesa. Ya salam. Aywa. Aywa. Inno la yashmul bisabt. Wa B. Sorry. Talata. Three.
A.
Wow.
A, letter A.
Min al A, awalan.
La, ahna harrakiz awi liyum.
So yeah, so I hope you get the idea of that one. So then that's a kind of a game to get the right order. Then I noticed that if we go back to the translation, there's the whole idea of being displayed. So yatim arduhu tamma plus al-master. That's quite hard for students at this level. The use of tam yutim plus the with the master. It's a great expression. It's really useful when you're translating and you get it a lot. And so I thought they need a bit of practice on that. So I gave them an example, tam yutim but with the bil master, to be completed, to be done. The book was published, the book will be published. I use simple vocabulary. Sorry? As if, yeah. So I got tam nashrul kitab, sayutim nashrul kitab, as a simple example. And then again, a gap fill, I've given them some, first of all, they have to match the masters. So they have to look at ighlaq, kitaba, fath, tarjama, ard, wa tadris. They have to decide awalan, which one goes with which. So although translation is, they've been given that one. And then they fit the master into those sentences, and a lot of them, and the sentences, I mean, I wrote them myself, I chose my own, you know, tam tarjamat riwayat nagi mahfuz ila 14 lugha, sayatim, what was it, tadris online. Of course, they have to decide if it's definite or indefinite. That's, they're capable of doing that, inshallah, they can hopefully do that. Sayatim ighlaq al mata'im wal maqahi limudat shahr bisabab waba, and so on. Again, I had to make sure the language simple, straightforward, to help them to have confidence in what they're doing. Because, you know, the stress of the high, you know, the translation work, it's all going into Arabic for a native speaker of English is always more challenging, obviously, than the other way around, usually. Yeah. Okay. So now that was text two. Now text three, bargaining, the last text. Here, I thought I needed to help them a little bit. I gave them some alternatives for the what I thought was difficult in English. Is only applicable. Bargaining is only applicable. What does that mean? You know, what about, let's say it's only to be found. That's enough. Partake. What does that mean? You know, take part, participate. To ask for, they might get confused with sa'al. So I thought request, maybe they hopefully know talab. Suggest here, you know, they've had arad yarid, so I thought maybe rather than iktarah, although, you know, they could use, we could give them that one as well. Then to earn a laugh, I could put to result in a laugh. So for them to think about the kinds of words that they would need. This time, they've got the translation, but the translator is not sure which version of the underlined pairs are grammatically correct. So let's have a look. Tujad aw yujad al musawama. Isah wa ghalat.
Tujad.
Sah aw ghalat.
Sah, tujad.
Tamam, alhamdulillah. Lay.
Bisabab al musawama, it has to agree in gender.
Bisabt, bisabt. So either to shari, yajib an tafham innaka aw innaha. Annak, sorry, annaka aw annaha.
أنك
أيوة بالضبط ستدفع ضعف الثمن على الأقل أو على الأكثر
الأقل
القاعدة هي أنك تطلب ثمنا أو ثمن
ثمنا.
ليه؟ Why is it ثمنا؟
مفعول به.
أيوه.
منصوب بالفتحة.
بالضبط. It's the or in English it's the object. It's the object of تطلب. You know. And then this. And this also gives you an idea as a teacher to check what they already remember from the year before, if they've done these rules, but it's a good bit of revision and it gives them a little bit of confidence to think, yes, I can see that's wrong and that's right, and to tell me why. And that, so that's the another exercise I thought, because I wanted to do different exercises for the different texts. Now, let's now go to the next one. Now, this is... If we go back, I'm sorry, if you notice that I looked, I put in highlighting yajib an, okay? Yajibu an, yajibu an tafham, annaka, walakin yajibu anna taltazim bi ardika. So you, yajibu an, so you have to. Now, of course, bil amaya in spoken Arabic, we don't say that, we use lazim, yeah? So lazim tifham, innaka hatidfa akhtar. So what I thought would be nice for them would be to, because I'm talking about the integrated approach, and that was one of my tasks that I wanted to make sure I did, my third grammar is to look at yajib and as opposed to lazim. So I've got also, remember that the verb to go in MSA is dhahaba yadhabu, whereas in most spoken Arabic dialects, it is rah yuruh. So we've got yajib an adhab, lazim aruh. I should go, I need to go. Yajib an tadhab, lazim turuh. You feminine, yajib an tadhabi, lazim turuhi. So that's, we will, hopefully you all know those in both Fusha and in Ammiya. Let's now do the little exercise. Okay, exercise 9. Translate the following phrases which are in both English and spoken Arabic, and then into spoken Arabic using yajibu an. The first one have been done for you. So yajibu an azur ukhti, lazim azur ukhti. Aywa, yajibu an azur azura ukhti, lazim azur ukhti. Min aiz yamil ba bil fusha wa bil amiya. She needs to buy a gift for her mother. Yalla.
Tamam. She needs. يجب أن تشتري هدية لأمها. لازم تشتري هدية لمامتها.
بس أيوة. أو سي, they need to travel to Dubai. مين عايز يعملها؟ في الفصحى بالأول وبعدين بالعامية.
لازم.
أيوة. يجب أن يزوروا دبي.
أيوة.
يسافروا نعم. لازم. لازم يزور دبي.
لازم يزور دبي. بالضبط. و D, you need to speak Arabic with the salesperson. مين عايز يعملها؟
Let's see. You need to speak Arabic with the salesperson.
Yeah, because I'm using the vocabulary from the text.
بالفصحى يجب أن تتكلمي مع يجب أن تتكلمي العربية مع البائع.
ممتاز وبالعامية.
بالعامية بالمصري أو بالليبي.
يا على كيفك.
ليبي نسمع الليبي. يلا بالليبي. لازم تتكلمي مع صاحب المحل ولا البايع.
مش بعيد عن المصري.
لا. فريدة.
إحنا جيران.
ودي ملاحظة دي ملاحظة جميلة جدا. إننا بنلاحظ إن التركيبة بالعامية هي في تقريبا جميع اللهجات. And I always refer to this as كأننا بنقارن ما بين Apple computer and Microsoft. So the dialects of Microsoft, I know Georgia knows my theory about Microsoft. So each dialect is a different make, it's Toshiba, Lenovo, but they all use the same operating system, whether it's Libby, Masri, Khaligi.
بس كلهم حلوين يا جونا.
طبعا وانا بفضل مايكروسوفت على الابل. لا بحب ابل احيانا لكن لا it's fascinating. So we learn, even as teachers looking at this, we really begin to think about how our teaching, how the dialects are working together. Now finally, the last exercise is where this is what we call a post-translation oral activity. Now they will have to translate at least one of those passages themselves. They can use the exercises to help, but they need to come up with their own version, which they do, and they experiment a little bit because they feel they have the confidence to do it. But at the same time, I want them to deliver an oral summary in spoken Arabic of any two of the three passages we've translated together. Mm-hmm. So in other words, they can choose the one about the bargaining, and they can put it into simple Arabic, you know, فسوق لازم تتكلم مع البياع فهو هيقول لك مش عارف ايه وانت بتقول, and they have to try and give a small oral presentation about one or two of the texts. طيب, so those are the exercises that I wanted to show you. So now I want you to think back about the exercises we looked at. So we had, and this is where I need Farida to help me. Farida, would you be able, my voice is getting a bit dry. Could you read out maybe the exercises again and ask them to think about each one?
Okay, so first we will order the preference. Okay, and then first we will order the preference, and then we do whether it's A or S, right?
Yes. Is everybody happy with AOS? Asynchronous, يعني هل التمرين ممكن يتم خارج الصف أو لازم يتم داخل الصف؟
داخل الصف. أنا مش بحب كلمة متزامن أو مباشر وغير مباشر. يعني بالعربي it does not reflect أي حاجة, وبالإنجليزي كمان بصراحة مش مفهوم قوي, بس أحلى حاجة إن يعني إنها
خارج الصف وفي الصف.
يعني في البيت ولا في الصف؟
بالضبط. okay. بالضبط. So A هيكون yeah. في البيت والسين صف. It's easy to
بالضبط كده. Okay. So key vocabulary matching. So are you happy to have this as the first one?
Yes. Yeah, so you decide. So you
the matching. The matching vocabulary. Mm-hmm. A. Okay. So someone said A. A. All right. أيوة ابعتوا لي في الشات عشان أقول كم واحد A. So I had two A for the first one. Okay, two, three, all right, three, four.
As your favorite.
Okay, could be both, A or S.
Yeah,
okay. Both, really. So one A or S, two A or S. All right, three. Okay, let's move to the second one. Match Arabic question A, the AQ question regarding the English text.
You remember where they had the questions? Meta Dakakin Maftuha fi Dubai, and they have to match. Yeah.
Based okay, on. Okay, let's start the vote.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
1, 2, 3.
1. Tier.
2. Okay. All right. Model translation with gaps, A or S? S. Okay. All right. S. ماشي. طيب. Reordering. Sorry. Model. We did that. Okay. Ordering model translation.
Yeah, where they had to reorder. You remember the sentences were mixed up and they had to reorder it?
Was this in English? It was in English, Jonathan.
بالعربي. بالعربي. لا لا لا.
بالعربي. بالعربي.
كان عندهم الترجمة, النصب اللي كان لازم يترجموها, ولكن الترجمة كانت already اتعملت, لكن كانت متشقلبة.
Okay. All right. Okay.
So the translation was jumbled. It was what we call an unjumbling exercise.
Okay, and then choosing the correct version of parts of the Arabic translation, A or S?
That was where you remember there were mistakes and they had to choose which was the incorrect version. كان في كان في مثلا جوز كان في الصح يعني كان في ترجمتين كذا عبارة.
Can I say something, if you allow me?
Please.
Yeah, I know that questions later on, but for me, both But it depends what I taught in the class. يعني شيني درست في الفصل على أساسها نقدر نقول كنا ممكن نخليهم يديروا في البيت أو لا. يلا أعطيتكم جرعة ليبي.
لا لا بالضبط. المشروع مفتوح. يعني ما فيش قرار نهائي إيه أفضل. عشان كده النقاش مفيد.
Okay. Grammar one. Passive participle. Gap fill.
With مفتوح. I remember we had القرآن 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 الكريم مكتوب باللغة العربية. What was the other one? الدكاكين مغلقة, whatever. They had to choose because that came up in the text that they needed to revise their passive participle.
Okay, خلاص كده. All right. So grammar two, تم يتم تم plus the master.
Yeah, you remember that one? Because they had تم يتم عرضه بالليل, يتم عرض الألعاب النارية بالليل.
بالليل. عشان نشوف. Okay.
And then.
Okay, I'll move to the following one. Grammar three, لازم
versus
يجي practice.
It's like في الملاكمة, فلان ضد فلان. لازم ضد يجب. لازم ضد يجب. مين المنتصر بقى؟ لازم ولا يجب؟
والله عمالة يعني شايفة بقوم زي بعض.
ده الأخيرة.
Okay. So, آخر حاجة. Post-translation oral summary.
Where they have to do their own oral summary.
The homework.
Yes. Well, that's right. So that's right. This is one. This could be asynchronous. ممكن they could record it at home and send it to you.
بس شغل كتير قوي يا سجام.
Yeah.
هيطلع روحنا إحنا كمدرسين يعني.
Yeah, of course. It is quite a lot. So again, you have to think about that as well. If you do it asynchronous.
فظيع.
Yeah. لو كان في البيت هياخد وقت. But you again, we need to always think about كل هذه العوامل لازم نحطها في الميزان.
عايز تعرف النتيجة؟
يا ريت. يلا.
طيب. Okay. So السؤال الأول equal. طيب يعني ممكن both وممكن في الصف. السؤال الثاني الصف واثنين قالوا both. ثلاثة كله قال في الصف. أربعة وأربعة في الصف أو both. خمسة نفس الحاجة equal. ستة واحد في الصف وثلاثة في البيت. سبعة اثنين في الصف وأربعة both. ثمانية أربعة وأربعة equal.
اللي تم يتم.
وآخر واحد أربعة وأربعة.
لازم. What about لازم لازم ويجب؟
لازم ويجب equal برضه.
والله.
مش
في الصف.
لا مش في الصف.
غريب.
أنا عندي يعني بس خلينا لما أنت تخلص نقول.
Yes. And then what about the oral summary?
The oral summary equal.
Okay. And which of the grammar activities did you like the most? Who liked واحد اثنين أو ثلاثة؟
بس في حاجة لسه ما عملناهاش to rearrange التمارين.
In order of preference.
In order of preference.
Well, let's just do, can we do a vote? Which was the one that was the most popular? Let's see which one came out the most. Which activity did you think is the most useful for the students? Bearing in mind that my aim is also the integrated approach, but I'm helping them to translate.
ناخد إجابة من حد يفتح المايك ويتكلم بليز.
الأورال سامري ده حلوة قوي لأن إحنا كمان أنا عندي فكرة هو ممكن ياخد التكست هو مكتوب يترجمه ممكن أنتوا تفصحى وبعدين عامية سواء بقى بالمصرية بالشامية بالدارجة بعد كده يتكلم يعني كتحدث في الصف وممكن نفاضل بين أحلى شغل أو ممكن إذا قسمنا لجروبس يبقى شغل حلو قوي ونبقى فعلنا في حاجات كتير قوي
وممكن حتى يكتب الترجمه وبعدين يلخصها بالعاميه
حلو قوي فعلنا كذا مهاره
أنا بستعمل ده كتير قوي.
حلو قوي.
بس بيحضروا في البيت ويجوا يتكلموا في الفصل.
بيحضروا في البيت يبقى شغل جروب اللي هي المتابعة الخارجية. حلو قوي وفعل كذا مهارة ويستخدموا بقى سواء دارجة شامية مصرية. حلو قوي.
طيب ده بالنسبة لل للسؤال اللي هو الأورال سامل. طيب حاجة تاني؟ ممكن حد عجبه حاجة تانية؟
ممكن أقول كلمة؟
فضلي.
كلمة اللي هي المساومة ممكن دي حلوة قوي يعني تبقى حاجة فن مثلا. طب ايه مساومة مثلا بالمصري؟ هنقول الفصال مثلا زي مثلا بالليبي بالشامي بالدرجة وتبقى حاجة فن واحنا استخدمنا وصلنا فعلا لإيدي المصطلح اللي هي المساومة الفصال. وممكن نعملها مثلا كمشهد تمثيلي بين الطلاب يعني حد بايع حد ويفتح الله ونستخدم بقى الاكسبريشنز لا ده كتير لا ده انت مثلا بالمصريه لا ده انت مغلواني لا ده انت بضاعتك
طب يا بالظبط بس ده هيكون جزء من الوحده كلها عشان كلها. ما
يعني اكتيفيتي ابلكيشن اكتيفيتي على المفردات على التعبيرات على الممارسه الاكسنت الطريقه بتاعه النطق حاجات حلوه قوي.
طيب السؤال اللي بقى وحد يقول على حاجة تاني يعني ده كان أحسن حاجة بالنسبة للكل.
نقطة بسيطة إن لو التدريب لتعلم اللهجة ما فيش فايدة منها حيكون كبيرة في البيت يعني أهم حاجة إن يكون الطالب في الصف معانا يتكلم اللهجة عشان يعني
بس بالنسبة now that بالنسبة للمحادثة now يلا نشيل موضوع ال integrated المنهج المتكامل من ناحية المهارات الترجمة من اللغة الإنجليزية إلى الفصحى ما هي التمارين اللي كانت محبوبة لديكم أكثر؟
بالنسبة للترجمة نحس بوث يعني يعتمد على إيش تم تدريسه في الصف يعني لأن اعتقادي الخاص يعني كل عمل بيتي يكون مفروض امتداد لعمل الصف.
أوكي. Good. أي تعليقات أخرى بالنسبة للترجمة؟
في حد كتب gambling phrases.
Jumbling and jumbling.
Jumbling phrases.
Yes, they like that.
Yeah.
Yes, I think that's
yeah,
what
yes.
Where the translation was jumbled up. You unjumbling, uh-huh.
That's very nice as well. Yeah.
Yeah, that's
and
very
it's
nice.
It's relaxing too.
Yes, and it makes them think a little bit. Yeah.
في حاجة كمان حلوة قوي عجبتني توظيف النحو بطريقة لطيفة قوي.
Yes.
حلوة بطريقة يعني أنت مررت. المعلومة النحوية الجراماتيكال بوينت تمرير لطيف جدا وفري يعني سوري فيري سموث للطلاب بدون اي تعقيد من خلال السياق حلو قوي قوي قوي.
شكرا.
احنا عندنا 7 دقائق فاضله فلو عندك لسه حاجات ثانيه جوناثان
yes, I want to just, yes I want to finish with the next slide yeah I mean of course انا عندي شويه محظوظ لان انا عندي خبره في كتابه كتب so I can انا بسرعه ممكن على طول انا اتعودت على كتابه تمارين وحاجات لان انا دلوقتي في نص تاليف كتاب جديد
معلش ثانيه واحده يا جوناثان ممكن بليز كله يقفل المايك ما عدا جوناثان وانا
Yes, yeah. So it's useful to have that experience. It helps a lot, but we can all do it. I mean, everyone, we're all capable of doing these beautiful. From what I can see, it's not difficult at all. And everyone has their own style, which is so nice, you know, and makes it so special. I mean, this is my style, but everyone has a different way of doing it. But the aim is to make sure that students are exposed to as much language as possible. Now, Yala Anabasaiza Kamil with the next point. Yes. So I had the, okay, I want to look at Lazim and Yagib. So I've put here, FIS A, as we said, is Kharig Asaf outside the classroom or synchronous FIS Saf or Fil Fasl in the classroom. This one, I personally, my view is I would do this one in the class, but how else, how Georgia, how would you do that one? The لازم and يجب.
أنا لازم and يجب بالصف.
بالصف. مش في breakout rooms.
يعني حسب الطلاب. حسب كيفية الطلاب. ولكن أنا بالنسبة لي بالصف لأن الطلاب يبلشوا يستعملوا أو يراجعوا يعني حسب معلوماتهم يعني لازم يروح ويجب المنصوب
بالضبط
نعم هاي فكرة إنه وجود
المنصوب
نعم وبعدين يعني ممكن أنا كنت أعطيهم تدريب يقوم به بالبيت
بالضبط نعم. ولكن الوجود كمان وجودك في الصف يمكن مهم هنا عشان مراقبة ممكن يعملوا بعض الأخطاء لأن مش سهل قوي يعملوها مين ما أنا مع جورجيا في الموضوع ده كلنا متفقين أو عشان فريدة أنت قلتي بعض المشاركين
أنا قلت ممكن يفك أنا عندي دائما مشكلة في الوقت إن أنا عندي بس 50 دقيقة وبنشوف الطلبة ساعات قليلة قوي في الأسبوع وكم الشغل جامد فعشان كده أنا بدي كتير من الشغل واجب في البيت بحيث أنه هو يحضر يجي الفصل يجهز يتكلم مش لسه هنخش البريك اوت روم وبعدين نضيع وقت وبعدين لسه هنعمل ويتكلموا كلمتين فاختصارا للوقت عارف لو فيس تو فيس يس في الفصل عندي مور كنترول لكن في البريك اوت رومز على ما بلف عليهم مش هيكونوا خلصوا
لا
وهيبقى عندي مجموعات شاطرة خلصوا بسرعة ومجموعات
خلصوا
عشان كده بدي كده في البيت يحضر ويجي بقى يقول
على فكرة الطلبة عندهم access to all these activities before the class anyway
okay
yeah right. they do have access to it so they have a chance to have a look طيب so oral summary yeah I think we what about the oral summary هل هذا ممكن يكون إيه أفضل أن يكون مسجل في البيت ويبعثوا لك التسجيل ولا يعملوه في الصف أو في بريك أوت روم زي رأيكم؟
أنا بالنسبة لي يقولوا يحملوه يحضروه ويجي يقولوه لي عشان ما عنديش وقت أقعد أسمع 30 واحد يعني عندي كفاية تصليح مش عايز أقعد أصلح بقى
Okay. Right. So finally, the mini task, maybe we don't have time, but it's something for you to think about to create another. Yes, sorry. Yes, the mini task, if this was a longer workshop, would be to think of another activity that you could create to about shopping. But we already had the suggestion, the wonderful suggestion, الاقتراح الممتاز من الأخت. مين اللي اتكلم عن المسرحية دي بتاعت الفصال في السوق؟
أنا نهاد يا دكتور.
فده نشاط جميل جدا اللي ممكن واحد يفكر فلازم نفكر في أنشطة طبعا أخرى إن شاء الله وآخر حاجة التأمل بقى. So الأسئلة هنا للتأمل هي how realistic is it to incorporate an element of spoken Arabic in an online class which is text based? So هل لو إحنا هنا المهمة بالنسبة لنا هي تدريس الترجمة هل واقعي إننا كمان نعمل يعني نراجع المهارات المحادثة العامية كمان في نفس الوقت هل هذا واقعي هل هذا is it doable يعني
and then I
hope so yes I think we've proven that it is possible I think today. If a spoken element is a part of it, does it have to be synchronous or asynchronous, or can it be both?
Can be both.
أعتقد. And then finally, does online teaching make it less easy to integrate spoken with MSA and necessary and means that we have to separate it? So هل التدريس online يعني إننا خلاص يجب يعني يجب فصل العامية من الفصحى أو ممكن نستمر في الدمج الاثنين
أعتقد إنها ممكن ندمجهم يعني خلاص تعودنا يعني.
Well, this is very very encouraging. That's yeah.
كان عندي حاجة ممكن أضيفها في ثانية.
أنا خلاص.
عندنا دقيقتين.
أنا خلصت.
جميل جدا يعني تسلم يا جوناثان جميل جدا وكل الأساتذة استفدنا جدا ما شاء الله احنا في كان حتى في مصر في كان إعلان بيقول ايه ده التطور الطبيعي للحاجة الساعة فده التطور الطبيعي للتعليم في العالم كله إيفن حتى لو ما كانش فيه الوباء ولا الكورونا، ده شايفه انه ده التعليم المدمج البلندد كلاسز هو ده مستقبل التعليم لحتى مشاكل اقتصاديه دنيا، هو ده الطبيعي، هو ده الطبيعي، يبقى في جزء وجها لوجه وجزء يبقى في البيت، لان احنا دايما احنا عايزين الطالب ينتج اللغه to produce language، تمام، يستخدم اللغه، يتواصل، يتحط زي ما بيقولوا ايه قدام نفسه عشان يضطر يطلع اللغة بأي طريقة هو عايزها بقى according to type of يعني هو سمعي بصري حركي أي حاجة الطريقة اللي تناسبه يستخدم بيها وينتج بيها اللغة ويتواصل، يعني فعلا الحاجة أم الاختراع
والشاطرة تغزل برجل حمار.
نور عليك جميل يا روحي جميل. على فكرة أنا ما عرفتكوش بنفسي، أنا نهاد الطبلاوي، أنا محاضرة الجامعة الأمريكية بالقاهرة.
تشرفنا. حبايبنا حبايب بقى.
حبيبي أهلا بكم. وباحثة في الدراسات اللغوية في جامعة الأسكندرية، باحثة ماجستير.
ممتاز. متشرفين. أنا إن شاء الله لو في مؤتمر في القاهرة إن شاء الله في الجامعة الأمريكية في ديسمبر، حتى ولو كان أونلاين، أنا حبيت أعرض الـ 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 الورشة دي إن شاء الله.
هم يعملوا حاجة ديسمبر اللي
جاء؟ أعتقد يمكن.
كمان أقول لكم على الحاجات الأبليكيشنز الأونلاين اللي إحنا بقينا نستخدم النير كود الكويزز، الحاجات دي أنا طبقت كل الكتاب الثاني كله بتاع دكتور محمود البطل وحولته لدروس ديجيتال ليسنز.
بجد؟
واو.
فدرس المؤسسات الاجتماعية.
أريد لو ممكن تشاري الإيميل بتاعك؟
أوكي حاضر.
تبيه لنا كده في الشات؟
يس.
حاضر. أنا هتواصل معي.
أوكي.
Yeah. Now, آخر حاجة أنا بس كنت عايز أقول إن دي عينة. لأن الكورس الفصل كله كل أسبوع الطلبة بيغطوا موضوع مختلف وفي نصوص مختلفة للترجمة، فالتحضير أخذ مني وقت كتير طبعاً. أخذ وقت كتير طبعاً. ولكن لو أنت متأكد أن الكورس ده هيتكرر السنة الجاية، أوكي، في فائدة تعملها، ولكن أخذ مني وقت كتير وتفكير طبعاً. كتير عشان انا ما انا قلت لنفسي الطلبه دول لسه يعني ده ستيل ما عندهمش خبره قوي مع اللغه، فمحتاجين مساعده، محتاجين زي بنيه تحتيه بالنسبه ل عشان فجاه يلا ترجم بقى. لا
طبعا
حرام
يعني. واعتقد اختيار التوبكس مهم قوي بقى، انها تبقى توبكس ما تخلصش يعني topics تعيش معانا، لان احنا بنعمل مجهود كبير قوي في تحضير الدرس.
بالظبط.
مش معقول كل سنه نغير ماتيريال.
لا، لازم يكون زي ما بيقولوا shelf life. وبي الميزه في حاجه زي الشوبينج ده يعني على طول، يعني الموضوع ده مش هيموت، لكن دي مصيبه تدريس الميديا عربيك، لان
الحاضرين عايزين الايميل بتاعك يا جوناثان.
يا ريت. انا فين ممكن هكتبه فين هنا؟
اكتبه في الشات.
في الشات. اوكي دقيقه واحده، انا بس اشوف الشات. ممكن اشيل الشيرنج. ستوب شير.
اوكي لا
خلاص. اهلا وسهلا. سوري
مين كان عايز يقول سؤال؟
بس الشير راح، لان السؤال كان معتمد على الشير. يلا معلش، خيرها في غيرها.
أنا بس هوت جون. أنا بتمنى إن في النهاية هيكون في قائمة عناويننا كلنا.
المفروض.
Jonathan.Featherstone. There we are. So Jonathan.Featherstone@ed.ac.uk. أنا حبيت أسمع منكم.
مش موجود يا جوناثان، قولوا تاني وأنا هكتب.
I know what I do. To everyone, let me do it again.
Jonathan Featherstone كلمة واحدة.
No, la la la. أنا بعملها دلوقتي. I didn't send it to everybody. دي مشكلة. At ed.ac.uk. شوفت دلوقتي؟
نعم. زهر.
موجود؟
أيوه.
Yeah. أي أسئلة تانية أو أي ملاحظات بالنسبة بالنسبة للتمارين أو الأسئلة بالنسبة للمنهج المتكامل وتدريس الترجمة بهذه الطريقة؟ هل تعتقد
أنه ممكن؟
سارة تفضل
يا جورج.
نحن وصلنا يعني الساعة 6:05. للأسف يعني لازم نخلص.
أوكي سوري.
لا أنا كتير 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 آسفة يعني أعطيتك آسفة. بس عم بينطرنا بالرابط الثاني بالاجتماع الثاني.
طيب شكرا جزيلا يا جوناثان، يعني ميرسي قوي حقيقي، يعني أنت أمتعتنا وكل الوركشوبس بتاعتك ممتعة وكل التريننج بتاعك ممتع، وأنا شخصيا استمتعت وأعتقد أن السادة الحاضرين كمان استمتعوا.
أوكي فرصة سعيدة قوي.
شكرا لكم جميعا.
فرصة سعيدة.
مع السلامة.
مع السلامة. باي باي.